And so our adventure begins.
In Maine.
Yeah, we're at Baxter State Park. It took us a little over 6.5 hours of travel time. And what's the time right now?
It's about three.
It's probably like getting near three.
3:05.
Oh, 3:05. And we still haven't gotten to the campsite yet.
We'll get there.
So it's very nice. It's a little cool. It's in the 60s, supposed to get down to 52. That's about it. The adventure begins, and we're gonna, hopefully we get some nice clear shots of Mount Katahdin, but right now it seems to be in the clouds.
That's right. Where I am, in the clouds.
Yeah, Carmen's in the clouds. Alrighty. There's streams throughout the whole park. It's beautiful. We're still not at the campground. We've been traveling almost 8 hours today. Today's September 7th, and they're already getting color change on their maples. Looks nice. So this campground is in a field. When I learn how to pronounce the name, I'll tell you. So we have a lean-to site. So, what's your first impression? Not good?
Well, we'll find out how we sleep, that's all. As long as we don't get bugs. This is all pretty.
This is our lean-to. We were fortunate that the people left firewood, because I didn't stop at the other campgrounds. I thought this was they would have had some here. Carmen's getting her bed ready. She's all hooded up. There's some bugs. Hopefully it gets down cold enough where they're not around.
Yeah.
Okay, so there are some bugs here. So I did this last time I was here. I ended up putting a tarp in the front so it encloses it, so it makes it more like a tent. So let me go ahead and open that so we can see what it's like inside, Carmen. Just open up the bottom there.
Oh, okay. It's got it closed.
Let's see what it looks like in here. It's kind of dark.
Oh, we got a light.
So this should keep the bugs at bay. So the lean-to, since there's no running water in Baxter State Park, there's a little path going to a water source. But we did bring a water jug with 5 gallons of water. I believe these are high bush cranberries. Follow the path. They have it so you can get your drinking water here.
We can bathe.
Yep.
No, we can take rocks back home.
We got lucky. We have all this wood here
in our backyard.
In our backyard, and we have a saw. And Carmen got birch bark. And what is birch bark good for?
Fire starter.
Fire starter. It's awesome. It's got natural oils. Burns when it's wet. And I have a saw. And we'll be sawing it up. So it's always worth bringing a little saw along. Very small, very compact. So what I did was I was able to cut it. I cut most of it. And then with a rock, I smashed it and it took it off. So these are nice round pieces. Those will burn a while. And it's all down, so we're not doing any live trees. There's a nice piece, hardwood there. You can saw it. Campsite's a little messy right now, still just kind of get organized. Carmen was out exploring the trails. So I keep this stuff in my car all the time. I've got a hatchet, a shovel, an inverter, DC to AC inverter, jumper cables, spikes if you ever need them to tie out anything, a knife, my saw, paracord, invaluable, bungee cords, a bottle jack, rope, fire extinguisher, a tarp, and over here I keep flares. So it's good to have, especially if it's normally your designated camping vehicle. It pays to have it in there. pretty neat the way these leaves are rolled up. It catches water. Bugs getting you?
They're a little buggy. As long as they're not biting.
We don't like bugs.
Don't like them flying in front of my face. Don't like inhaling them either.
So yeah, we looked on the map, and this is definitely Katahdin, and then you can see the knife's edge in the middle there. So I'm also out here with my camera. So there's my It's a really nice night, except for the darn bugs. Oh well, these are nice photos. You can't get this all the time. Last time I was here, there were no clouds. It was kind of boring.
The lighting of the fire.
There's an egg carton down below. And near the sun. There's an egg carton down there.
Oh, okay. There's a birch.
All right, Carmen's got a good fire going. Setting it up nicely in here. All right. So it's set up nicely. Carmen's got her big mattress. I've got a Therm-a-Rest, and then I also have a one of the egg carton ones under it. Just in case it gets cold, we have the heater, but I don't think it's going to be as cold as what we originally anticipated. Nice area, good campsite. Alright, so it's 6 o'clock in the morning. It was the worst sleep we've ever had camping, right?
Yes, actually it is.
I don't know. Just kept waking up every half hour, hour, had weird dreams. I ended up having a nightmare. It's pretty spooky. So It's chilly outside. I don't know what it is. So we got the lantern going. And I'm glad we brought the heater because it's going to warm this place up nicely.
Yes, thank God.
Then we heard a guy. He was quite a distance from us, and he was...
He needs a CPAP.
Yeah, he was snoring all night long.
Yeah. First time sleeping in a hat.
It was a little chilly. But we're working on it. We'll be getting up and getting some coffee pretty soon. And
double espresso.
Double espresso. Sitting by the heater.
Yes.
So last night we came out to the field and the stars were just everywhere. Okay, so a little bit about Baxter State Park in Maine. It's primitive camping. There's no running water, but they have water sources, or you bring your own in. They recommend that you treat the water. They have porta potties. There's no showers. So this is good camping. Let's see what time it is. So it's 7:15. Carmen's getting ready, then we're gonna head out and begin our adventure. There's so many hikes to do, and there's so many water features, as in waterfalls. We were going to hike the owl, but instead of devoting 6 hours to just one hike, we're going to do a little bit of everything today, because we're only here for 2 nights, 3 days. I was here 7 years ago, and I got a chance to climb Baxter Peak, or Mount Katahdin. That's an awesome hike. I highly recommend this place. It lets you connect with nature. And Carmen's a good sport, because a lot of girls wouldn't want to go to a place where there's no showers, there's no real toilets or flush toilets, no running water. But like today, I boiled water, so got a chance to, you know, I think one of the greatest feelings if you're in kind of cold camping is that hot washcloth on the face in the morning. That just welcomes the new day. Makes you feel fresh. So here's her porta potties. That's all she wrote. All right, so we're getting ready to hike. We're on the Appalachian Trail just for like a mile and a half, or 1.2. We're gonna go see Little and Big Niagara Falls. Just gonna fill out our names here. Oh, that's what's making that noise? Oh.
They have, remember that walk we did?
Yeah.
Oh,
it's fine. That's pretty cool looking.
Yeah. It's like it's grabbed the tree. I mean the rock.
Grab the rock. We're gonna go see Little Niagara Falls right now.
We did it.
Perfect.
We did it.
Little Niagara Falls. I guess since we didn't sleep last night, this would be a good place to sleep. You always smile when you walk by. Perfect. Where are we heading?
To the Big Niagara Falls.
A big old raven. That's a big bird. Bonnie and Clyde.
What time is it?
12:30. So we're hiking up to Katahdin Stream Falls. It's a nice day. It's
beautiful
like
day.
Mid-60s, right?
Yeah, about that. Had a nice lunch.
Yeah. Then we took a nap in the car.
A little bit.
A little bit. Needed to recharge the batteries. Our batteries.
Yeah.
All right. Not many people on the trail because most of them start in the morning.
Yes.
So this is going to be good.
All for us.
So this trail isn't bad to start.
Nope.
We only gain, I don't even think, 1,000 feet of elevation. Going smooth, Carmen?
Yes. This is my kind of trail.
Yeah, this is a nicely groomed trail. Okay, so now it's starting to get a little steeper in grade. So nice hearing the noise from Katahdin Stream. Not noise, but the sound. Katahdin Stream to the right side of you. Trucking on up, huh?
These aren't wet.
Yeah, that's why tomorrow would be no good.
Oh yeah, because of the rain.
Because of the rain. This is nice up here.
Yeah.
It's very mossy.
It is mossy.
those nice greens. Tanya, we really needed to get back out to nature, recharge our batteries, get away from all the crap and sad news every day. You just got to get out and make your own adventure, no matter what it is. Just do it. Get out. So if we had continued on with our hike to the Owl, we would have taken this trail another 2.6 miles up. Still another 4.1 if you go to Baxter Peak or the top of Katahdin. We're going to go a few more tenths of a mile to the waterfall. Okay. Yeah, that's a tough word. I'm sorry. This is Abel Beach picnic area, and there's a loon out there. I wonder if they're gonna be able to pick it up. Okay, so we're doing our little outro on Baxter State Park. What'd you think?
Oh, beautiful scenery, lovely.
Yeah.
Hikes were great.
Yeah.
Our nights.
We'll see, yeah. Tonight we're hoping for the best. It's definitely a great place to go. It gets you away from, everything, because there's no cell service. You got your pit toilet.
Yes.
And it's got good hikes.
Definitely good hikes.
Nice lean-tos. There's a lot of water features, a lot of waterfalls you can go to. That's a lot of fun.
Yes. And even little, like a little beach, you can just sit there and relax. And even we saw some loons today.
We saw some loons and they were out there calling, yeah. So that was pretty cool.
That was really nice.
So yeah, this is definitely a good place to go.
Just to get away from all the rigmarole. This is good.
Yeah. Just to recharge our batteries, right?
Yeah, I agree.
Okay. Alrighty, well thank you very much for watching and we'll see you next time.
Bye.
This is Stump Pond. I'm glad that it's raining on the day that we're leaving, so it makes it easier. Not even out of the park yet. Our campground is 17 and a half miles from the ranger station.